Hello, 217 students. We're going to talk today about tissues and how you're going to be looking at them in lab. You're going to be seeing tissues in lab for a whole lab, and you're going to learn a lot of different things about them. And hopefully I can give you some hints here on how to pull that information together so you can have a good time at getting a grasp on all these things. You're going to be looking at tissues all through 217 and 218. So this skill, along with microscope skills, is something you definitely need to have. Almost everything you can touch, everything you can look at in the body is a tissue. There's very, very little there, a few fluids that are not tissue. And if you're thinking blood is a fluid that's not a tissue, nope, blood is also a tissue. And you'll find out in lab why that's true. In the human body, we have four main tissue types, and you're going to learn each of these: epithelial, connective, muscle, and nervous tissue. And you're going to learn the main general things about them, the functions of these tissues, and the structures, how they're made. So you're going to look at what do the tissues do, and how are they built. You're going to look at this about the four general types, but you'll also be looking at it in terms of specific tissues that represent different types. You'll also be looking at slides, and some of the slides will look like this one. It'll have a lot of different looks to it. You can see here we have some very darkly staining areas that look pretty different than some middle portion that's light and dark, and then wow, over here this looks different and this looks different, and you'll see things like that where there's a bunch of different things going on in the tissue, and maybe things are at different magnification. So you're going to have to get a handle on things like this in order to be able to figure out what you're actually looking at. And you may see things like that and go, oh my goodness, how on earth am I going to sort this out? Well, today we'll talk about a few things that hopefully will help you to do that. But one thing I want to say to you first of all is you walk into this class, as much as you don't know anything about tissues perhaps, you walk into this class knowing some stuff. You may not know tissues yet, but you know how to look at something, say like this, and see that, wow, that does not look the same all the way through. There are things about this. As a matter of fact, if I could make pictures like this and throw them at you in class and give you a pencil and say, you draw circles around the places that look different. You might put this as one type of thing, and you might draw a circle around this to say it's a different type of thing, and a circle around this to say it's a different type of thing, and you'd be straight on the money there. This is mostly epithelial tissue, this is connective tissue, this is smooth muscle tissue, and all of those look very different. And you can see, whether you know what kind of tissue they are or not, that those are different things. So trust your instincts, trust the skills you bring to this class to get you started on the road. You also are going to want to know, and you're going to have to know anyway, because we're going to test you on this and quiz you on this, what's the function of a tissue? What is its job? What does it do? And you're going to have to know the structures. How is it built? What does it look like? But you know what? If you know these, it's going to make looking for things on slides that much easier, because you start to know where to look, why to look there, and all of that. Now, this is a boatload of information, and it is going to be absolutely natural for you to say to yourself, let me just work on the slides here. I'll get that other stuff at home. And we understand that there's no way you're going to get it all in one lab period. But the more you can incorporate all these aspects, the things that it says in the textbook or your instructor says about, here's what its function is, here's how epithelial tissues are made, and what you're looking at on slides, the more you're going to be able to get a handle on it. Another awesome idea is for you to look over the lab before you go to lab. If you've looked at these major types and seen some of the ideas about them, maybe even drawn yourself a table, a chart, or a concept map to help you make that text information visual. If you don't know this already, you're probably a visual learner. The majority of people are. You may not be, you may be a verbal learner, but most people are visual learners. And the more you can take things that we usually learn by text and turn it into something visual, like a table or a chart, And have that by your microscope even while you're looking at things. The more you get to pull in these ideas of tissue characteristics to help guide you when you look under a microscope. One of the tissues you'll be looking at in lab is epithelial tissue, and we'll tell you a lot of things about its structure and function. It tends to make sheets, and it tends to line space. That's just a little bit of what it's about. But if you know this, then when you see a picture like this, if we go back to this one, the first thing you can think is, well, this is a tissue that lines space. Where's the space? If I go to space here, this is where food moves through the gut in our cross section of a small intestine. The first tissue you can touch is your epithelial tissue. Now, it's not all this, and you'll have to learn more about that in lab, because epithelial tissues are also thin. But that's going to help keep you from trying to look deep in here to see your epithelial tissue. We could use these things when we look at muscle tissue as well. For instance, if you see some things about muscle tissue and notice that muscle tissue cells are huge, like whopping huge, like phenomenally huge, some of the biggest cells we have in the body. And they're very long, long and cylindrical, and they have striations. Well, then when you see something like this under a microscope and you see these cells are so big they won't fit on in your whole field of view, they have striations, they're cylindrical, you can say, geez, I wonder, those must be muscle cells, skeletal muscle cells. Also, maybe knowing they help you to move things through the body, that would be smooth muscle or cardiac muscle, might help you know, oh, there's absolutely got to be smooth muscle in the wall of the small intestine, and we see that right here. Okay. Another tissue type is connective tissue. And for example, one of the functions of connective tissue is to bind things together. And strangely enough, here between our smooth muscle and our epithelium and glands is this connective tissue binding the two different types into one intestinal wall. So that could be a hint. Another thing about connective tissue is there is tons and tons of something called matrix. Matrix is a product of cells, and most of our tissues, epithelial, muscle, and nervous tissue we'll look at in a minute, don't have much matrix. It's mostly cells. Connective tissue might have a lot of matrix. So things like the fibers that we have in here and this background substance, which in this case is probably kind of a gel, is not cells. We have cells in here. These things are cells, but not all of it is cells. And that's a good hint that we have connective tissue. Also, the fact that we do have fibers is a good hint that we have connective tissue. Knowing these things about the tissue will help you start to identify it when you see it under a microscope. The fibers here that we have, the goop behind it, and then we see these dark round spots. These are the nuclei of various connective tissue cells in this tissue. And don't worry if you're not getting the details here. That's for lab. What I want you to get is the idea of what kind of information is going to help you when you're looking at these tissues. Nervous tissue is another one, like muscle or epithelium, that's mostly cells. And like muscle, well, like skeletal muscle, we have another very distinctive cell type here called the neuron. These also are whopping huge cells, another one of the biggest ones in the whole body. And they have strange projections on them that make them look what we call stellate, like a star. They're sticky out parts. And they have the nucleus in there. And they're so huge. And you might not realize right away when you look at this that it's that huge unless you look at what magnification you're at. But if you look at this and realize after a minute that these darker spots are the nuclei of smaller cells, that tells you this has to be very big or this has to be very small. These are the kind of things that you'll start to get a handle on. In this case, this cell is whopping huge. And these are cells that are closer to average body size cells. These are called neuroglia cells. They're supporting cells of the nervous system. If you can get these kind of things, what a tissue does and how it's built, then when you get to a slide like this, you're going to know where to look. And whether the slide is labeled as ileum, that's the organ that this is part of, a section of the small intestine, which it may be, or if it's labeled with something more specific, like simple columnar epithelium, which it may be, because we do like to put slides out for you and tell you which tissue on the slide we want you to look for. But if you picked up a slide labeled simple columnar epithelium and found this, you have to be able to understand that everything here is not simple columnar epithelium. Again, in this case, we'd go to the space and go to the first tissue it touches, and it's just a tiny thin layer right here that's our simple columnar epithelium. Maybe the slide would be labeled smooth muscle, which is found in here, or serous membrane would be an even thinner than all the rest tissue lining this space on this side. If you stay focused on the characteristics, the things you want to put away and study before the quiz, if you stay focused on those while you're looking at slides, what is a function? What is a structure? That will tell you what things might look like and where they might be found, and that's going to help. Okay. And if you take the time to practice, this does not come overnight. Okay, you do need to practice with the microscope if you're not already adept at it. And if you're not, please don't think you won't be. Using a microscope is like driving a car. There's a lot of little details. But after a while, those become dead easy and you can do it all on autopilot. Just give it time. The strongest recommendation I can give you, though, is don't limit yourself. Look at as many different preparations of something as you can. It is very natural to want to grab one slide or one picture and try and memorize that, because it starts off being confusing. But if you do that, I guarantee you we're going to throw a slide at you or a picture that doesn't look like what you have been studying. Look at as many different versions as possible. Yes, there's differences, but after a while, the more you look at, the more you see what is the same in every single version, and then you know what makes that tissue that tissue. Then you know what's at the heart of it. So look at different things, and you can use your lab manual, which has various things, Rust, which has various things, and the internet. And you can do Google image searches using the word micrograph or histology as part of your terms. If you look on the Moodle site, you'll find a couple good histology links, and your instructors may also have some recommendations for you. If you do these things, keep characteristics in mind and take the time to practice on different preparations. When you see a slide like this, this is something, by the way, you'd see in 218. It's an artery and a vein. When you get to this point, and certainly earlier in 217, you'll have no trouble navigating this, trying to decide what you should be looking for and identifying those things. It can be pretty straightforward. And if you do take that time, you too can master tissues. Thanks for your attention, and we'll see you in lab.